Check for me, less you got checks for me. I kept a stick like a hobo, no checking me. Way back when D-Lo had the spot in Treasure Street. So many they get a vasectomy. She left her body home and brought her neck to me. I did a walk through, they sent a jet to me. Yeah, no price less than my travel fee. One of my arms worth a ticket. Watch so much that a car came with it. Back in the day, I used to rob with no mask on. I wish I would've killed the whole house for. And I went to school high, I ain't go to class though. I was with the OGs, learning about the glass though. Call me with the dudes, five mama kid. Break yourself, leave the brains on the dashboard.
Yeah, y'all. Welcome to the lab. It's your boy, Coach T. Today, we've got my guy, man, Savon Presley from Warlord Hartridge, class of 2022. One of the most, you know, I hate that word, underrated, but one of the biggest underdogs in the class of 2022. Bro, I appreciate you coming on the show, man.
Appreciate you having me.
Absolutely. You know, I had to get you, man. I definitely had to get you on the show, man. I hit him up a minute ago, like, yo, bro, I know who you are. I gotta get you on the show. Just give me some time to come check you. So I'm definitely appreciative of him coming on the show. So you know how this goes, bro. You know what I mean? Let's tell us how you first picked up the rock, and what age you picked it up, and what age you took it serious.
So the first time I picked up a rock would have to be around like 7, 8, but like not crazy, like recreational, you know,
right.
Playing the parts with my dad and stuff.
Right.
But like I started taking it serious probably around like 10, 11 years old.
Right.
I played my first, you know, AU team. Played with the Pirates, you know the Pirates.
Yeah,
right?
Georgia Pirates. Yes, shout out to the Pirates. Yes, sir.
Pirates.
Okay.
Played a couple of Zoo Crew, playing Zoo Crew too.
Okay,
shout out to my first tournament.
Okay. Okay.
So it was lit back then.
Yeah, definitely. That's definitely a grassroots team. Definitely probably throughout Jersey. I definitely know them. So shout out to them. Shout out to all the grassroots teams, man, from the middle school age zone. They don't get a lot of love. Shout out to all you guys. But I'm okay. So boom. Take me to your 8th grade year, right? I'm going right to 8th grade. Because in between, I know
first,
you got
second,
the...
My second class. My reclass year or my first?
Let's go to your first year. I didn't even know your reclass. Go to your first year. Your first year, 8th grade. Talk to me about that. You going into... You playing... If you still... Who you playing with AAU at this
Bulldogs.
Time?
Bulldogs. I've been playing with the Bulldogs for a while.
For a while? Yeah, okay. Shout out to the Bulldogs. I love their program as well. Bulldogs. Shout out to the Bulldogs. So you're playing with the Bulldogs. 8th grade, yeah. How that's looking before you reclass? First of all, how was the season for you? What was one of your best memories, and what made you go into reclassing? Those are the three questions. But we could go with the eighth grade year. But what was your best memory?
My best memory had to be when we went to Florida.
Okay.
For nationals.
Okay.
We played the ESPN Worldwide Center.
Yes sir.
It was lit. My best memory had to play. We played a top 5 team in the country at the time.
Okay.
Yeah, it was all 6'8", 6'9", some tall, man. It was tall. But, you know, we was killing them.
Right.
They came back for me. They was shooting mad threes. It was getting N1. They was cheating to the rest. It was cheating, OD.
Always cheating. Out of town, man. They always, wrong.
Yeah, it was cheating because it was from down there. So, you know, we was always, like, on the downside of that. But, you know, we came back. My boy Kwan, you know, he always coming, killing. He was killing my boy, you know, Noah Harris.
Yes, sir. Noah Harris. Shout out to Noah. Facts.
Yeah, Noah, Corey, you know, Corey Fuller.
Yes, sir.
We had a team back then.
Yeah, the squad. Yeah.
He was killing, but that was one of my best memories back then, playing a big time team, you know, just killing them, come back. Yeah.
So, after you come back from AAU, 8th grade, yeah, you said you reclassed. What made you go into the reclass? Like, what made you decide to do that? What schools are you looking at, and what made you ultimately decide you can't know I'm a reclass this year?
Well, we did it as like a team because the Bulldogs, yeah,
okay,
Tequan and all them.
Yes, sir.
We all went to TPS for the reclass.
Right.
We all went there.
Right.
And a lot of my boys, we was like, you know what?
It makes sense.
Let's reclass.
As a group, yeah, and then try to, all right, I see what y'all was doing. Okay.
Yeah.
That makes sense. That whole, yeah, I said that 8th grade team that year, y'all was loaded. I remember that.
Yeah.
Y'all was making noise. Corey Floyd, you, Tequan, Noah. My son Joe,
yeah,
like y'all had
a
nice squad, yo.
Yeah,
y'all
nice
was
squad, yeah.
That's a fact. You know what? Now that you say that, I do remember. I remember seeing you. I do. I do use a backhoe with Noah. Mm-hmm. I mean, a bunch of guard, but I remember you. I remember now. I remember that. I'm glad because I didn't remember that until you said it just now. And now it's replaying in my head. I'm like, snap. I do remember.
B-Ball Spotlight is one of my favorite ones, too. Yeah, we played Terrence Clark team.
Right.
We played Lightning. We played Lightning, too.
Right.
We was playing. Yeah, we was, yeah, was Riverside.
We was giving out L's that tournament. Yeah, I was handing out L's. That's a fact, bro. Boom. So then, going to the Patrick School. Mm-hmm. So then, going back, going to the ninth grade, most of you guys, but let's be talking about you, decided to go to different, y'all don't stay at the Patrick School, you guys go to,
Well, Quan did.
Quan, right. But you wound up going to...
Bishop R,
yeah. Right. So let's talk about it, your freshman year, let's get into that. Your freshman year, you had Bishop R. I mean, you had a solid freshman year,
yeah.
Like 7 points, two assists, two rebounds, two steals.
Two steals, yeah.
You know what I mean? You got a solid for a freshman playing varsity, you know what I mean? It's solid. Yeah. Solid numbers. So talk to me about your freshman year.
So my freshman year, I didn't know what to expect going into the year, to be honest with you. My first time playing high school ball, you know.
Right.
I was pretty good going into the season, you know. Summer league, we was doing good. Fall league, we was doing good. And then, you know, I got the first start, like the third game of the season.
Okay.
You know, then I started rocking from there. We was doing good, you know. I was putting up numbers. I had my career high, like 14 points.
A couple games after that.
Yeah, so I was rolling.
Right, the early in the season against, I think, like Spotswood or something
Spotswood,
okay.
Yeah, my career high.
Absolutely, yes, sir.
Yep. And we was on, like, a winning streak, you know, all that. And then after that, you know, we lost in states.
Which I made it to states after that, because I think previously before that, I don't think they had made it.
Nah. Right? And we won the division that year,
and
too.
Yeah, won the division. So you had a solid,
first time
solid,
since,
right,
like, 19-some.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
S3.
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. So talk about that experience, being a freshman playing varsity. I mean, you know how to go into, you know, but this is your experience personally, because a lot of times we think, like, and we was having a conversation before this, and I'm like, yo, it's, of course, the boy. And I've done a lot of energy, like, a lot of freshmen, especially in private schools. It's more so in private schools than anything. Like, if you're a freshman, even if you're playing varsity, you're not playing like that. That's the classroom that's playing, and that's just really how it. So I just, you know, I was telling, like, that's really like that. I've, like, across the board, especially in private schools.
Yeah.
It happens in public, but heavy in the private schools, man, upper class and play. That's unless right. You're coming in and you're like 6'9", yeah, and you really, right, like, man. You know, like, it's
one
not.
One of the top players in your grade.
Right, it's not like it. So, but go ahead, so talk about that experience, bro, and what it did for you, like, both negatively and positively.
So, positively, it made me, like, a stronger person, because, you know, playing first, I wasn't used to playing against bigger guys, seniors, these older dudes, like, all these reclass kids, you know,
right.
it was a new experience for me. So
right.
It made me get stronger. It made me mentally better.
Right.
You know, think about the game more. Let it come to me more. Because my freshman year, I was like, you know, I was just doing whatever. Like, I mean, I had to think now. My sophomore year coming up, I had to think more.
Right.
And yeah, I was more experienced. So that was the good thing about it. And then negatively wise, I had to say, like I said, it made me, like, I was like, wow, like, doing stuff that I wasn't thinking about doing.
Right.
And all that stuff. So
basically, like, you just more under control.
Yeah, under control.
Going into
so much,
you know, as your freshman season, it was a learning experience. You were a freshman, you playing ball. Mm-hmm. You hype.
No,
I wanna.
Yeah,
you
exactly,
know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I'm in high school, I'm playing ball, so it's like you was just playing maybe too fast or playing, trying to force things that, you know.
Not letting the game come to
you. Right, letting the game come to you. But that comes with maturity, like you said, man. Now you learn. That's the great thing about that experience, that you actually know. Not just saying, y'all learned something, let me move on. You know exactly what you took from that experience and then was able to translate it going into your sophomore year.
Yeah.
So going into the summertime, AAU, who'd you play with ninth grade year?
I started off with the Panthers.
Right.
I played one tournament with them, and then I went with Sports U.
Okay.
So I rocked with Sports U a couple of times.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. Dope.
Went to Atlantic City.
Right.
Played there.
Who that team was playing? I think it was Mo playing on that
Mo,
team?
Mo,
yeah,
Mo
I like some squad. Yeah.
I don't know if you know my boy Bakir.
Yeah, I know Bakir. Yes, sir. Bakir Cleveland. Yes, sir.
Him. Who else? Justin.
Okay.
Played with him, too.
Yeah, you got a nice squad, man. You got a nice little squad. Okay. Yeah. How was that experience? How'd you guys do?
Oh, we went 2-1. We lost the takeover.
Okay.
We lost the takeover. Team Grant.
Okay.
Lost to them.
Tough team as well. Okay, so now you sometime, you know, I know you wound up transferring to Woodlaw Hartridge. What made you decide to transfer going, and what made you go to that school in particular?
So basically, you know, I wanted a new start.
Right. Right.
I wanted a new start.
Right.
I wanted to build off my own team. You know,
right.
Lead my own team.
Right.
Coming off a team where I was like six, seven man. You know.
Right.
Being a role player, like
right.
I wanted to be the man. Like I wanted to lead my team. You know.
Right.
Be the prime example.
Yeah. Okay, so you just want to basically you want a bigger role to.
Yeah.
You felt like, and that's the thing. Like, it's one thing to want a bigger role. It's one thing to be ready. You knew you felt you was ready. Like, all right, I'm ready now. I know what I did. I know what was hindering me before, and I'm ready to make that change.
Yeah, build off my freshman.
Exactly. And you wanted the opportunity to be able to. Because sometimes, if you feel that way, and it could be true, you might not be able to get the opportunity where you at the time. You know what I mean? You need that opportunity, the platform to do so.
Yeah.
So you, all right, so you wound up going there and sophomore season. You know what I mean? Monster season, 22 points, right? 22, yeah. 23 points a game. 5 rebounds, almost 4 assists, 7 steals, bro. Strap up, 7 steals, bro.
Number one in Jersey
in steals, 160 plus steals on a season.
Yes, sir.
You understand, bro? I was that's for the first call. I'm like, yo, what? Who's strapping 90 feet? Because if you get 7 steals, you picking up 90 feet at least a quarter of the game, bro. There's no way you're getting that many steals. I'm like, I don't care who you playing. 7 steals are 7 steals, bro.
Yeah.
7 steals are 7 steals. I don't care who you playing. Not real talk, bro.
Yeah, so it's hard. Like, people don't understand that. That's hard to get. That's real hard,
it is, bro. It definitely is. That's more the energy and effort, so I definitely appreciative of it, and I'm not gonna wait till later to talk about it. Like, nah, let's talk about that now. Let's show that attention to them now. Let's give the props to defense that is due, because that's crazy, bro. I don't care who you, like I said, I don't care what, nah, 7 steals, bro. It wasn't 2 or 3, 7.
That's yeah.
Like,
yo, bro. A lot.
So I know you had a career high 36. You had a few. I think you had 36. You had 30 twice.
36 and 33.
Right, you had 30 twice. Man, so let's just go, man. I can't even. First of all, let's talk about the first game of the season. You came out wilding.
Yeah.
7 threes the first game. Like, 29 clipped that first game.
Yeah.
Let's talk about
7
it.
7 steals that game.
7 steals that game.
Yeah.
Let's talk about coming in your first game. So, what was your mindset?
I ain't going to lie. I was a little nervous, you know. It was a lot of hype going into that game.
Right.
A lot of people there. A lot of media and all that.
Right.
You know, it's my first game after my freshman year.
Right.
You know, coming off a loss my freshman year for state. So, I'm
right.
Like, all right, you know, I got to bounce up back off this game. And I got to come out with a lot of energy, lead my team, be the vocal point that they need for my team, you know.
Right.
So, basically, we was down. First quarter, we was down, like, 13, 14.
Okay.
And we was not having a good game. I had 2 points going into the first quarter. After the first quarter, I had 2 points.
Okay.
So I'm like, all right, nah, that's not gonna happen. I gotta do something for my team.
Absolutely.
Know? Second quarter, I started wilding. I had like four or five threes in a row. I'm like, all right, then I'm feeling myself now. Yeah, so I had like 14, 15 going into half, you know. We was
right.
up, we was finally up, we was up like 5. Then my man's Makai in my backcourt, he got foul trouble.
Right.
So it was just me. So you know, I had to leave my team. You know, I'm getting steals, rebounding, doing everything for my team.
Right.
You know, I'm shooting more. And I pulled up right before the third quarter, like almost half court, made it. Crowd was going crazy. Oh, it was crazy, bro.
Crazy game. Yeah, but you feel like that was the best season? That was the best game of the season for you?
It's up there.
Yeah, but you had other
my best game.
Let's talk about the best game.
Right, my best game is when we played St. Joe's.
Okay.
Yeah, we played St. Joe's. Yeah, it's first round. We was 16th seed. There was number 1 seed.
Okay.
We went to their house. Now right. Last game of the season for the county, whatever.
Right.
So we played them. We was not supposed to be there at all.
Right,
like,
16-16.
We was down. Everybody was counting us out from the jump, even before we even started the game. All the media was talking about we're going to get blown out.
Right.
Blah, blah, blah. So I'm like, all right, I gave us motivation. So, you know, we down. We come up 9-0 on them, like, real quick. They called timeout. We was rolling. Then they came back. They had a little stretch. And then, you know, it was going back and forth.
Right.
And then going into, like, third quarter, we was down 10. Came back, you know. We was wilding, had mass steals, and then we went to overtime, and I got injured, and it was over after that. But I had 29-9-8 that game, so I was wilding too.
29-9, those numbers, yeah. Triple dub vibes,
yeah.
Man, triple dubs.
Wilding,
let's
bro.
Talk about that 36 point game though. Let's talk about that.
That was
game.
Real. You know what's crazy? That was a real calm 36.
It's a calm thought, I
swear to God.
It be like that sometime, bro.
That was real
it
calm.
Really be like that sometime.
I thought I had like 20. I checked the score. I'm like, the box score, I'm like 36. Damn.
That's when you know. That's when you know you're the groove. Because it's effortless. You feel like you got 20, but you that's when you probably were so efficient that game.
Yeah,
that you
I
just
was,
like,
I
that.
Was,
that's
yeah.
Why you felt like you had 20.
Yeah.
Or play 18, like, oh, yeah, I made all 8 of my shots. Like, nah, you didn't count the free throws or other shit. Like,
yeah,
you want to have been 36, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, oh, man. But overall, what would you guys rank? You had a successful 18 season.
18-7.
Not bad
was
at
5-17 last year.
Last year, the year before, right? So look, you know what I mean? That's what you wanted to do that,
yeah.
Right? You wanted to go into a role where you had it, the keys. You had the keys to the car, and it was yours to do with and lead, and you did that. 18-7 from 5, and that's crazy, bro.
Yeah.
So I got to congratulate you. That's
Thank
dope
you.
On that.
That.
That's super
that.
Dope. So you guys wound up going to, like a successful season. You guys wound up losing the counties in the chip, though, right? Or into the, in the, sorry, not in the chip, in the first round of counties.
And then you lost by three, though.
So a tough team. And then you guys, but you still got it. Guys made it to states. Mm-hmm. So now you in states. I know you guys was you didn't have a high seed in states either, did you? You played Trenton. You had one that
was 8-9. We was the eighth. No, we was ninth seed. They was the eighth seed.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. So eight. Yeah, I know what I'm saying. I know you guys weren't playing Trenton.
That was the only game I didn't play because I was hurt.
Yeah, that's what I was about to ask you. I know you didn't play that game. I know you. That was tough, man. It would have been probably a different outcome. I know, even if it wasn't, I know you would have had. I know you was gonna put it on. No questions asked.
Yeah. Everybody. A lot of people said it. They came to that game to come watch me, but right. You know, I couldn't play.
Right. So. What did you hurt? I know you got hurt the game before. Your ankle, right? Yeah. You got it before you. Okay. Yeah. So that was a tough. Oh man, that's definitely tough, man. Yeah. That's tough. So now you know we're going into sophomore season. I mean, and going to sophomore AAU course. You know we got no AAU COVID. We know you running with already as far as, you know, sports team. You know that the real you. I forgot. I don't want to mess up the name. Yeah, right. I know you was looking to do big things, and you know, I guess try to up your stock. And like I said, we was having a competition even before today. Like as far as the just do, right? You feel like you're not getting your just do, and I feel the same way. As far as, and it's not so much recognition, but it's just like, okay, it is recognition, but it's this recognition. The pitching position where you could be recruited. That's because every time people get it, it's like some kids might want recognition just because clout, right? Yeah, but a lot of kids don't. Like, I know with a situation with you, like, all right, I'm trying to go to school for free. Yeah. So I know that I'm right now, I'm on the right trajectory, and I just need the right exposure so I can, you know what I mean? So I'm not, you know, so I definitely understood that. And like I said, numbers speak for themselves. And I know, like I said, the conference you were in was definitely a tough conference, but it was like the division that you were in. But like again, the opposite of that, even though the division was weaker, you still was consistently putting up numbers, took no games off. Nope. Numbers were steady across the board the entire season. Yep. And like I said, I know kids in better conferences that take games off when they play weaker teams. You understand? Yep. Bro. And that's why I'm like, nah, bro, just keep. It's a testament to the work you're putting in, and just keep that same mentality. You know what I mean? But you definitely need needed a bigger platform to definitely, you know what I mean? Play, not even play with, but play against bigger teams. You know what I mean? Like I said, I'm not big on, I know you need that sometime, but I'm fine with it. To go into a team where it's like, okay, but I'm playing the bigger team. I'm getting an opportunity to showcase my skill and show you what I can do against the top talent or who's considered the top talent at the time. Yeah. You know what I mean? So I definitely understood that. So it's just, you know, matter this marathon, bro. I told you before, it's going to come. Keep that chip. That chip is going to keep you going.
Yes, sir. Go a long way.
Never get comfortable. Never people start getting comfortable. They'll get little security blankets, not a challenge. I think it could. Keep that same energy, bro. Yes, same energy. Going into next year, you going back to Woodlaw?
No, I'm transfer.
Yeah. All right. I know he's not sure yet, y'all, what school he going to, but he knows.
Stay tuned.
Right. Stay tuned, y'all. Man. Check him out. They definitely make the commitment. Yes, I'm looking forward to it, bro. What is your ultimate goal? Like, not your ultimate goal. Let's keep. What's your short term goal?
My short term goal.
Yes. Like, what do you see yourself in the next? What's this? Your sophomore. For the next 3 years, your first. Like, where do you see yourself at? Matter of fact, what's your dream school? I know you want to go to school for free, so I'm not even going. That's what I was waiting for. But I know you want that. What's your dream school first? That's
my dream school. My favorite college school team will always be Kansas.
Okay.
I like Kansas.
Okay.
I like
Kansas
the coach over there.
Right. Right.
I like the players that come out of Kansas.
Right. You feel like it fits your style.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. The little guard they be always Devontae Graham. That's my favorite guard.
Right. I got you.
We got Dotson right now. They always got them guards. That's always got their chip on their shoulder.
Bro. You speaking facts. That's why I know you're doing your homework. You know, a lot of kids don't know. I like the school because of the school, but you just said something that I like this school. I like the guards that recruit. I feel like I fit my style. You're probably the first kid to say that to me, bro. Live, bro. Real talk. So I know you actually doing your homework. How's your grades, bro?
Oh, I got like a 3.6.
See, that's it, man. 3.6. That's really what it's about. What's your favorite subject in school?
Math.
Yeah. See, I hated math, and I'm glad. That's dope, man. We need more people that like. A lot of people don't like math, man. We need more people that like. I couldn't stand math. We need more account people. Be able to count that chicken, man. We need more sports agents. More team owners, and that definitely takes some math. But big NBA team.
I'm the Lakers.
Lakers all
LeBron,
the way.
LeBron, I always be a
LeBron. Talk about that kid playing LeBron. All right, that's it, hands down, bro. Yep. Hands down.
I like to look at the guys like John Morant.
Okay.
Kemba.
Yes.
Kyrie,
yes,
Chris Paul, like guys that's not that tall, right. I could base my game off of and fit little things that they got in their game and put into mine.
Okay.
Yeah, I like that.
What do you think is one part of your game that's like, that you don't, you feel like you don't get enough credit for, that you know that you do well? Because like I said, if, like you hear your name, they're going to say, oh, he get buckets. Mm-hmm. Or some people might say he's, you know, he play defense.
Yeah.
Like I said, you do both for me. But what do you feel like is like, okay, this is the part of my game I don't get enough credit for?
I have to say my facilitator.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Facilitator. Okay. I can get a lot of guys involved.
Right.
Like, and real easy.
And you play the two. You wasn't even a point. You play the two guard. Still got four assists.
Yeah.
So I can imagine you running the rounds at the helm and still getting, like I said, well, you do four assists playing the two. So I definitely, I can agree with you on that one. I definitely want to see you get an opportunity to do more of that facilitating. You know what I mean? As a point guard anyway. But definitely, bro, when we get out of here, you already know.
Appreciate
the vibes, bro. I got to, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
I had to pull up with my boy.
That's tough.
Rightfully so.
Appreciate that.
You know, Clayvon, I appreciate you, bro. Everybody, man, stay safe. Y'all know the vibes, man. Strap up. Get buckets. Kill Bill Lab Work. Stay in the lab, man.
Yes, sir.
Stay in the